The Philippines drops 4 spots in this year's Global Talent Competitiveness Index. The index by Business School INSEAD ranked Manila in the 84th spot out of the 134 nations in terms of ability to attract and retain talent. The Business School said the Philippines is regarded as a talent laggard. This is the country's lowest placement since the index started in 2013. Now, which countries are at the top of that list? They are Switzerland, Singapore, and the U.S.
Two major Philippine conglomerates eyeing a joint venture for the tollway business. Can you guess who? It's San Miguel Corporation and Metro Pacific Investments. In a disclosure to the stock exchange, the Ramong Ang-led SMC confirmed reports of the possible JV relating to the construction, operation, and maintenance of the Nasugbu-Bawan and the Cavite-Batangas Expressway projects. News reports had cited MPIC Chairman Manny Pangilinan as saying they are giving up at least 40% of their joint equity in the tollway company. San Miguel now says it will make further disclosures once agreements have been reached. Here's a look at the latest corporate earnings reports. Megaworld sees its net income for the first 9 months of the year soaring to 13.5 billion pesos. That's up 39% and pulling away even higher from its pre-pandemic levels. Meanwhile, the Ayala Group's renewable energy arm, ASIN, says it ended the first 3 quarters with a net income of 6.6 billion pesos. This rise is thanks to gains from the sell-down of the firm's geothermal power plants in Indonesia. As for Robinson's Land, its net income for the 9-month period rose by 31% to reach 8.8 billion pesos. And finally, hotel and resort developer Boulevard Holdings reports its consolidated sales for the month of October hit 1.9 million pesos. This represents a 6-fold increase from last year's figures. The manufacturing sector is seen as a sleeping giant that can boost the country's economic growth. Jackie Pascual reports.
The Philippine manufacturing industry needs some help from both government and the private sector. This was one of the assessments at a forum organized by the Philippine Economic Society and Strat-based ADR Institute. Former NEDA Secretary Ernesto Pernia said the country's manufacturing sector lags behind some regional neighbors because of many factors like low foreign direct investments and other internal concerns like corruption.
The current status quo makes it quite challenging for the Philippines being the laggard in to advance to its manufacturing sector. Enhancing the manufacturing sector, as our ASEAN peers have, requires ample foreign direct investments and of course domestic investments and the capacity to export, which is facilitated, among others, by FDIs themselves.
Pernia cited the BSP data showing that FDI to the Philippines in 2022 amounted to $9.4 billion, much lower than Indonesia's $21.4 billion and Vietnam's $17.9 billion. This also affects exports, with the Philippines' exports to GDP ratio at 13.8%, lower than Vietnam's 104.2% and Malaysia's 63.3%. Other analysts agreed that the government must attract more investments in manufacturing by resolving issues on corruption and by upholding the sanctity of contracts.
It's turning out to be sluggish yet again. Really quite painful, a challenge to do business here.
Rule of law, perception of corruption will always threaten any interest for investment. So side by side with encouraging an investment-led growth is really improvement with regards to greater transparency and accountability.
The Trade Department has partnered with USAID, Makati Business Club, the Advanced Manufacturing Workforce Development Alliance, or AMDEV, to help the manufacturing sector by upskilling or reskilling about 11,000 workers. USAID will fund $5.2 million, while the private sector will match it for the initial five-year program. AMDEV head Danilo Lachica, who is also president of the Semiconductor and Electronics Industries in the Philippines, said this program is much needed for workers to learn the so-called IR 4.0 or the Fourth Industrial Revolution skills such as AI or the Internet of Things.
IR 4.0 is because of IoT, because of sensors, because of, you know, connectivity, you have machines now talking to each other. Not all companies or industries are in the IR 4.0 regime. Yung iba nga nasa 2.0 or 3.0.
Improvement of employability, reduce unemployment and underemployment, and accelerate human capital development in the country, particularly in the manufacturing sector.
The said program is expected to beef up the manufacturing industry in the country and attract more foreign investments to the Philippines. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine factory output sees a 9.1% growth in September. That increase follows the 6.8% expansion in August and 4.5% growth recorded in the same period last year. The biggest spikes were seen in the manufacture of coke and refined petroleum products, which were up by over 78%. The manufacture of electric equipment saw a 26.5% increase, while the printing and reproduction of recorded media was up 17.6%. There were also upticks in the manufacture of basic metals, transport equipment, as well as in beverages and electronic products.